Welcome to Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Today's topic is collection of primary data through questionnaires. As in the previous video, we already discussed about the different methods of data collection as a classification of primary data and secondary data. So in today's video, we'll discuss about the questionnaire which comes under primary data collection method. What is the meaning of questionnaire? What are the merits of questionnaire? What are the demerits of questionnaire? We'll discuss here. Before starting the video, I want to say you that if you like my video, please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Before starting the video, I want to give the classification of primary data collection method for the new viewers who first time view my video, who first time see my video. So what is the classification of primary data collection method under which questionnaire comes? Basically, there are following types of primary data collection methods. First one is observation. Observation method is already discussed in the previous video. Second is interview method. Interview method is also discussed in the previous video. Third is collection of data through questionnaires. This topic is discussed in this current video. And next is collection of data through schedules. I will discuss this in upcoming videos. And the last one is other methods. Other methods include so many methods by which we can collect the data through primary data collection method. This will also discuss in the upcoming videos. So in the today video, we'll discuss about the collection of data through questionnaires. So what are the questionnaires? What are the meaning of questionnaire? Basically, questionnaire is a list of questions directly or indirectly related to the field of inquiry. What is the research objective? What is the research purpose? What is the research problem? According to that, a questionnaire is prepared, which may be direct questions, which may be indirect questions related to the research objective. This method of data collection is quite popular, particularly in case of big inquiries. When the research topic is so large or we have to collect the data of so many persons, then we can generally use this method. So it is a popular method of data collection which comes under primary data collection method. This method is being adopted by private individuals, research workers, private and public organizations, and even by governments also. As this is a very popular method, it is generally used by research workers, researchers, students, governments, and other persons, other organizations also. So, this is a very popular method in the field of research. A questionnaire consists of number of questions. It may be printed or typed in a definite order on a form or set of forms. So when we are collecting data in the form of questionnaire, then we have to prepare the question according to a particular sequence related to research purpose and research objective, which may be in the offline form, in the online form. If it is in offline mode, then it is in a printed form. It is in a hard copy. When it is in an online form, then it is not a printed form. The dictionary of statistical terms defines the questionnaires as a group of a sequence of questions designed to elicit information upon a subject. So the dictionary of statistical terms define it as a sequence of questions for a particular subject. According to Wilson G, who describes a questionnaire as a convenient method of obtaining a limited amount of information from a large number of persons or from a small selected group which is widely scattered. According to Wilson G, he describes questionnaires as a group of questions which are answered by a small number of persons or large number of groups which may be scattered or not. Third definition is given by Bogardus. According to Bogardus, a questionnaire is a list of questions sent to a number of persons for their answers and which obtains standardized results that can be tabulated and treated statistically. So according to Bogardus, it is also a group of questions which is sent to number of persons for giving answers and by which we can tabulate that answers and treated them statistically also. So this definition is given by Bogardus. In the questionnaire method, a questionnaire is sent usually by post to the persons concerned with the request to answer the questions and return the questionnaire. So in this method, the questionnaire is sent when it is in offline mode, offline form, which may be in the printed form, sent to the persons and requested them to answer these questions according to the research objective and research returned back to the interviewer or researcher. The questionnaire is mailed to respondents who are expected to read and understand the questions and write down the reply in the space meant for purpose in the questionnaire itself. When the questionnaire is the online form, online mode, then it is mailed to the respondents to read them, to understand them and write down the reply in the given space and return back to the interviewer or researcher. The respondents have to answer the questions on their own. The method of collecting data by mailing the questionnaire to respondent is most extensively employed in various economic and business surveys. So it is a very popular method of collecting data through questionnaire by mail. So what is mailed questionnaire method? In this method, a questionnaire containing different type of questions on a particular topic, systematically arranged in order with elicit answers of the type yes or no, or multiple choice questions, MCQs, are sent out to the prospective informants along with a polite covering letter explaining the aims and objects of the inquiry, objects of the research. These questionnaires, duly filled by informants, are received back by the authority in a specified time. So in the mailed questionnaire method, a group of questionnaire or form of questionnaire is mailed to the informants who given their answers according to research objective and sent back to the authority, which may be researcher or interviewer. So this is the mailed questionnaire method. A large number of private agencies like finance companies, financial institutions resort to this method of inquiry for a collection of material. The success of this method depends upon the precautions taken in respect of two things. First one is covering letter, second is questionnaire. In the covering letter, all the related topics which may be research objective, research methodology is pointed out for the purpose of respondent so that he or she can easily understand about the research objective and give their answers according to research objective, and the list of questionnaires also. So what are the covering letter, what are the questionnaire, what are the precautions taken in covering letter and questionnaire, I'll discuss here. So first one is precautions for covering letter. The covering letter should be carefully drafted to win the cooperation and confidence of the informants in the supply of data. For this, it should be politely worded. It should highlight the aims and objects of the inquiry or research. It should assure the informants that the information given by them is kept strictly confidential. It should assure the informants that a copy of the results of the inquiry or research will be given to if they desire so. A self-addressed and stamped envelope for the confidence of the informant on sending back the questionnaire should be attached. So these are the precautions should be taken by the researcher in preparing the covering letter, and they will ensure the informants for the privacy and security of the answers given by the informants also. Now we are discussing here the precautions taken in the formation of questionnaire. Questionnaires are the more popular means of collecting data but are difficult to design and often require many rewrites before an acceptable questionnaire is produced. The questionnaire is the only media of data collection, and thus it must be carefully planned so that all the aims and objects of the inquiry are fulfilled. So questionnaire is formed in such a way that it completed the research objective, research motive and the purpose of the research also. So these are the precautions taken in the questionnaires. द मेन प्रिकॉशंस आर फॉर दिस द क्वेश्चनायर शुड बी सिंपल एंड शॉर्ट. द नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चनायर्स शुड बी फ्यू बट एडिक्वेट. द क्वेश्चन शुड बी स्पेसिफिक एंड पिन पॉइंटेड. द क्वेश्चन शुड नॉट हर्ट द सेंटिमेंट्स ऑफ द रिस्पोंडेंट्स ऑल्सो. इट शुड नॉट रिलेटेड टू जेंडर, कास्ट, रिलीजन, स्टेटस. ऑल्सो द क्वेश्चन शुड बी अरेंज्ड इन अ लॉजिकल ऑर्डर. सो दैट वन बाय वन आंसर्स गिवन बाय द इन्फॉर्मेंट्स. नाउ वी डिस्कसिंग हियर द मेरिट्स एंड डिमेरिट्स ऑफ द क्वेश्चन आयर्स. व्हाट आर द मेरिट्स एंड डिमेरिट्स? फर्स्ट वन इज मेरिट्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन आयर. देयर इज लो कॉस्ट इवन व्हेन द यूनिवर्स इज लार्ज एंड इज वाइडली स्प्रेड जियोग्राफिकली. वी कैन इजिली मेल द क्वेश्चन आयर टू द सो मेनी पर्सन, सो मेनी इन्फॉर्मेंट्स. इट इज़ फ्री फ्रॉम द बायस ऑफ द इंटरव्यूअर. एंसर्स आर इन रिस्पोंडेंट्स ओन वर्ड्स. So answers are given by the respondents by his or her own opinion. The respondents have adequate time to give well thought out answers. Respondents who are not easily approachable can also be reached conveniently through mail. Mail method of questionnaire. Large samples can be made use of and thus the results can be made more dependable and reliable. We can collect the data of large sample by the method of questionnaires also. Now discussing here the demerits of questionnaire. What are the demerits of questionnaire? There are few demerits also of questionnaire. Low rate of return of the duly filled in questionnaires. Bias due to no response is often interminate. It can be used only when respondents are educated and cooperating. The control over questionnaire may be lost once it is sent. It is answered by only the respondents. It is difficult to design a questionnaire in a proper manner. Some other few demerits also in the questionnaire, which are there is inbuilt inflexibility because of the difficulty of amending the approach once questionnaire has been dispatched. There is also possibility of ambiguous replies or omission of replies altogether to certain questions. Interpretation of omission is difficult in this case. It is difficult to know whether willing respondents are truly representative or not. This method is likely to be slowest of all because it is a time taken process. It is given by the respondents according to his own time. Before using this method, it is always advisable to conduct pilot study, pilot survey for testing the questionnaires. In a big inquiry of significance of pilot surveys felt very much. Pilot survey is in fact the replica and rehearsal of the main survey. Such a survey being conducted by experts bring to the light the weaknesses, if any, of the questionnaires and also of the survey techniques. From the experience gained in this way, improvement can be effected. So basically private survey is very helpful to modify the questionnaires to improve the questionnaire according to research objective. So it should be done by the large inquiries for large research objective also by the bigger organizations. So this is all about the primary data collection method through questionnaires. I again summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic, which is questionnaire. Questionnaire is basically the data collection method in which there is a list of questions which may be asked directly or indirectly by the informants. It is a very popular method and adopted by the public and private organization, research workers, private individuals and governments also. It may be in the printed form or it may be in the online form also. There are several definitions given by statistical terms of dictionary, Wilson, G and Bucardus also in their own way. This method is done using by post when it is in the offline form and it can also be mailed when it is in the online form. Online form is the less time taken process and it can reach to the large number of population. In this method, there's two important points for taken under consideration, which is covering letter and questionnaire. Covering letter is very important for any questionnaire because it should provide the confidence to informants to give the right answer in the timely answer, and it gives security and safety to the data given by the informants also. So it should be politely worded. It should highlight the aims of objective of inquiry, and it is very a self-addressed and a stamped envelope is also important for the covering letter. Now we are discussing here the precaution of question IS. What are the precaution? It should rewrite before acceptable question IS produced. Question IS should be simple and short. It should be specific. It should not relate it to particular sentiments of the respondents also. What is the merits of question IS? It can reach up to the large population with low cost. It is free from biasness, and respondents have adequate time to give their answers. There are few demerits also of questionnaire. There is low rate of return of duly filled questionnaires, and it is possible when respondents are educated and cooperating, and it is very difficult to design the questionnaire. And the last point is that it is very important to give to do pilot study before finalizing the questionnaires for the proper sequence of questionnaires, as it is a rehearsal of main survey. So this is all about the questionnaire method of primary data collection. If you have any query about this topic, or if you want to know about any other topic related to business management or research methodology, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We will meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you, everyone.